The next day you go in and they has little ones. You don't call them biscuits. And if Africans come to America and got little babies, they're Africans. Okay, I know you don't like that when you look in the mirror because you can't think you're an African. But anyhow, I have no objection at all. My children, I have a daughter who's a Jehovah's Witness. I have...
Does that bother you?
No, it don't bother me because I train my children. And I know what they believe and don't believe. And in fact of her being a Jehovah's Witness, when problems strike, it's Big Daddy they come into. I know that. And my daughter was trained to be intelligent, that you don't pray to stop getting pregnant. You have to do something about that. You gotta go either to the drugstore or a gynecologist. You pray all you want. If you're having a man, the praying will stop the pregnancy. You understand? But birth control will. Okay, the pill will help. Now, that's reality. I'm not going to tell my daughter, you believe in God, if you've got a man, pray, and the boy will make you pregnant.
Okay, but I can think of a specific example. People who may be physically ill would not go to the doctor. I'm thinking of one particular instance that I know about.
Right.
Lady would not go to the doctor because she said she'd rather be in church.
She's going
to
die soon. I do not want a minister when I get hit by a car. I want a specialist in bones.
Well, let me take you for a moment. Let me use myself for an example. I was bleeding to death. I was going to die. I was losing blood faster than the doctors could give me. And they said, we must operate. And there comes a priest to say something over me, whatever it is. I told him, I don't need him. I want a doctor.
That's right. That's intelligent.
He's standing in the way of the doctors. They need to work in me.
It doesn't mean that he doesn't believe in God. It means that he's intelligent.
And this is 1963.
Because the priests want the same doctor. If the priest had an accident and the doctor comes up and another priest come up, and when he look and he has a ruptured aorta or something like that, you think he's going to tell the guy, pray, man, I need that, and tell the doctor, go, he's going to tell the doctor, get me to the hospital. When you go to the hospital, how many priests, ministers you will see lying up there getting treated? Because they got sense. You know what I mean? You know, it isn't irreligious or godly for me to say, I fell down and broke my leg, and then say, Father, straighten it out. You know what the Bible said? I will help those who help themselves. Well, the Bible could be real for negative and positive. It got all kind of negative and positive. And the whole thing is your interpretation of it. You go to 15 Baptist church and you get 15 back. Why tell me now, if it's religion, that you got one block 200 feet long and got 6 Baptist church in there? The same Baptist denomination. Tell me
why.
If you're a Christian, why you need a Methodist, a Baptist, a Presbyterian, a Catholic, and it's the same Jesus?
Why?
Money. Big business. Everybody want to run their thing. If I get 10% from you, 10% for the next guy, 10% of $70,000 a year is good loot. I mean, I could get a few Cadillacs behind that, and a nice home, and a nice wife with a mink coat, and you see some people taking the last dollar and giving to the church, and then come and ask me for my dollar.
Let me just, because I've been informed that we have about, I guess, less than 5 minutes, maybe 3 minutes. We've covered a lot of subjects. We've had a lot of questions. And I guess in just maybe a minute summary, each of you, I mean, we hear about this stuff maybe once a month, Black History Month, mm-hmm. and we go back for the other 11, living our lives, being bombarded with other kinds of information. What can we take from here, and what can we do with it, and how can it help us? I mean, that's a multifaceted question, but if you can, let me start with you, Doc.
What I would say is that I would advise anyone to start reading and researching on their own, because I don't know of any school that educates. I've been trying to find a school that does.
What
and
do
all of them, as far as I find out, all they do is train people to be a bunch of regurgitators. So I say to my students that you have to go out and take that training that you receive and then make it work for the benefit of yourself and your people, and then you show me that you are one who are now happen to be an educated individual. So you have to keep reading, and it will benefit you in the long run.
Well, is there any value to what we've been doing here for the last hour?
Yes, because now We have brought a tremendous amount of new information, hopefully, to light, and other people will start trying to check us out, and then they, too, will become enlightened. We hope that they do try to prove us wrong.
But you probably also offended a lot of folks.
Well, look, new knowledge does. If someone tells you that your girlfriend that you love so well is a prostitute, and you've never seen her prostituting, it's shocking. And if you catch her, you really can't believe it. You might even kill the guy for telling you. So I'm not surprised if it hurt. Because when you start to change or deal with people's belief pattern that they have held on so dearly to, and many have even offered to fight, give up their lives for their belief, only to find that the belief is untruth.
Okay, we just have a minute left, and I know that's not a lot of time, but final statement on your part, Dr. Ben.
God is truth, they said, and truth is a constant effort of research. There is no limit to truth, and one must look constantly to find truth. I've traveled this entire world. I didn't sit one spot and read one book. I went to thousands of libraries over the age. I'm 64, and I've been, from 1938, I have been doing research in the area of African people.
Do you think you've been making any progress, making any difference in people's lives?
Progress is a relative thing. It all depends on what you're equating from what point to where.
Okay, we only got 30 seconds left, so. Yes?
No, we haven't made any progress if you look at percentage-wise. We, and the college campus we are now, professors, let's say, okay, where we got 5 professors and 1,000 students, one time we had no professor and 100 students. It doesn't make any difference. The percentage is worse now.
Okay, we're out of time, and we want to thank those of you at home and those of here in the studio. If you'll stick around, we'll talk a little bit more. But we hope you found something very interesting and stimulating, and I know you've got something to think about. Thank you very much for joining us. Good night.